Okay. So, I know you've been in the clinic before for a few different types of treatments. And I'm just curious as to why you're looking at craniosacral therapy and bone manipulation as a type of therapy. What's brought you here today?
I've been suffering with a bit of anxiety.
Okay, and you just want to see if this type of therapy may be of some help to you?
Yes.
Okay. So I'm just having a little look. What I think I'm going to do is position myself behind you and just start to have an assessment and a physical examination of the cranial bones.
Yeah.
Now, it may not feel like I'm doing much when I'm examining, but I am feeling for very, very slight movements, and we'll be doing some gentle movements just to change the positioning of the cranial bones.
Okay.
Because it is anxiety that you are coming in for, I'm also going to look at some facial manipulations as well, focusing on the jaw, cheeks, nose, and eyes. And we may need one or two follow-up appointments, but I'm hoping that these gentle movements should improve the overall blood flow to the area.
Okay.
Should help to release tension and will allow me to feel if there's any build-up in the bone areas.
Okay.
So feel free to just close your eyes, and I'm just going to readjust myself behind you there so I have a better range of movements for assessing the cranial bone. The bones of the skull, the cranial bones. Okay, so it may not feel like I'm doing very much, but I am just gently rocking and just pulling apart those cranial bones and see if there's any misalignment or sometimes gentle movements can help relieve headaches, tension headaches, and improve blood flow to the brain. I'm just starting out on the sides of the head. especially with conditions like anxiety, craniosacral therapy can actually help. It takes a more holistic approach to the health of the brain. Can't be used solely on its own because there's many factors that play into anxiety and other mental health conditions. So again, it may not feel like I'm doing very much, but I am feeling very slight movements to the head and the cranial bone. this feeling on the mastoid bone behind the ears. And the bone that leads to the temple. We have something called fascia that connects our muscles and our bones, and it covers everything. When we become anxious and stressed, this fascia begin to cause some problems. Which is why a massage is so good for anxiety. Just lifting the head up and relax. Okay. So now your head is resting directly on my hands, and I'm just moving my feet to feel these very, very slight movements of the cranial bones. And as I'm moving them, I'm feeling where there's tension. When we are born, as you may know, we are born with our cranial bones not yet attached to each other. And for one reason or another, as we mature into adults, our cranial bones can have implication on other areas in our health. So I'm just trying to assess and manipulate the bones, just relaxing the head. When I move my hands, just feel the weight of your head. Don't try to move for me, because I want to feel Are you in any discomfort?
No.
Okay. Sometimes when I do this movement, some people can feel certain muscle pains. And deep tissue massage help. and cranial sacral therapy and facial bone manipulation is my specialty here at the clinic. I've done years and years of research. Try and understand how the bones on our face and head have implications on our wider health. I'm just using the palms of my hands to apply some gentle pressure to the top of the cranium. And then some slightly more targeted pressure and some pressure points. Making sure you're straight there. Some more pressure point release. And then next I'll move on to some manipulations of the face. And the jaw. The orbital bone. Cheekbone. Follows all the way around. And the cheekbones, the teeth, the nose, and then moving into the neck and spine. Just taking a look at the symmetry of the face. Thank you. and remembering the face is made up of muscles, cartilage, as well as the bones. And we can do some manipulation of the ears. Some gentle pulling. So for the facial manipulations, I'm going to raise your head slightly, okay? And this is because with some of the movements that I'm doing, I don't want the blood to rush into your brain. I want to make sure that you're comfortable. And then I'll be able to just start on some of those facial areas. Just doing some gentle pulling motions. Very nice high cheekbones. Which give the appearance of a more sculpted face. So I'm just going to ask you to just release your jaw. That's right. Just as I move my hands, just relax the jaw there. Okay. It might feel a little bit difficult if you're not used to just doing some jaw. Just opening the sinuses now. Feeling on the jaw. Now I'm going to do some nose and now I don't want to block your nasal passage, so I'm just touching on one side at a time. Just moving any mucus build up there. And then around the orbital bone, just very gently hooking and pulling. And pulling, doing some whole face movements here. So I've attempted quite a few facial cranial manipulations there. Any points that I've found that may have been sticking, I have attempted to loosen, and with a follow-up assessment, I'm hoping this may relieve some of your anxiety, along with some talking therapy and a healthy lifestyle.